Last week, right here on the show, we got the scoop on the upcoming TEDx Providence event, which is coming up this weekend. And here in studio this morning is one of the speakers at that great event, Kimberly Cowell Arcand, visualization lead, excuse me, this is why I'm not speaking.
It's a mouthful.
For NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory. Good morning, Kimberly.
Good morning.
So nice to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Speak a little bit about what it is you do, because this, we were talking about it earlier this morning. It's a remarkable, line of work that you've chosen here.
Yeah, it's actually a really cool job, I won't lie. So I work for the Chandra X-ray Observatory, which is one of NASA's great observatories that goes about a third of the way to the moon, and it looks at the X-ray universe, so things like exploding stars, colliding galaxies, merging black holes, the kind of boring stuff in astronomy.
Yeah, well, I don't think any of it's boring, really. It's so very fascinating to me. When you were young, did you have this affinity for space? Did you know that someday you'd be doing something like this?
Well, I didn't know that I'd be doing it, but I sure wanted to. I mean, I had one of those little white plastic space shuttles and I'd zoom in around my room, but I knew I would never be able to handle that sort of bumpy ride into space. So this is a good job.
I'm still playing with space shuttles in my room.
Good, that's good.
But let's talk about the big event, bringing your knowledge to the stage here in Providence for TEDx Providence. What can people expect when you take the stage?
Sure. Well, I'm going to be talking about how to hold a dead star in your hand, which is essentially this, a tiny version that I happen to carry around in my purse. Mm-hmm. And it's essentially the first ever 3D print of an exploded star.
Yeah, that,
so it's pretty cool.
That is really cool. You were showing that to all of us. We're all a little bit mesmerized, just kind of staring at that together. But when you can sort of bring this knowledge to that stage and share it to a wide audience, whether it's in Providence or any place, what does that mean for you getting that knowledge out about your field?
Oh, I love it. I'll be honest. This is the type of job that I think a lot of people don't even know exists. I mean, I use data of the universe to tell stories, essentially. So it combines a lot of different things, obviously the science and technology, but also things like storytelling and art. So it's a type of job that I think a lot of people could be interested in.
Does the storytelling aspect of it maybe sort of bring it around? Some people might think, oh my goodness, she's so smart. I mean, I feel smarter just sitting next to you. But some people might think, I'm trying to follow, but you can kind of bring it all together and really humanize it.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I'm no Einstein. This is a job that you train for just like any other job. So it's totally reachable.
And what does it mean for you overall to be a part of TEDx?
I'm very excited. I love TED Talks. I mean, one of my favorite contemporary musicians I actually found out about on TED.com. So to be able to have those curated stories that you learn so much about, it's a perfect way to take a lunch break.
Well, it's going to be just a tremendous event, and we can't thank you enough for sharing some of your time with us.
Thanks.
Here today. A pleasure to meet you, Kimberly.
Thanks.
If you want to hear Kimberly speak at TEDx Providence this weekend, just head to roadshow.com for all the ticket information.